Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey and you're watching another Photoshop tutorial. This week, I'm going to show you how to make a triptych image. What's a triptych image? Well, it's a picture that's made of three separate panels. Now, each of those panels could have a separate picture, but I'm going to show you how to make a triptych picture using just one photograph. Okay, so where do we start? Well, we're going to start with a blank canvas. Go to File, choose New, and I'm going to use the international paper A4 size. Now, it's got to be in landscape format, so we need to turn this on its side. So we go to Image, Rotate Canvas, 90 degrees, clockwise. And we're going to need two of these. So let's go back to Image and choose Duplicate. So I've got two identical A4 canvases. I'm just going to minimize one because I only need one to start off with. So what are we going to do with that? Well, what we're going to do with this is to make this into the right size and shape for one of the panels of our triptych image. First of all, I don't want my triptych image to be filling the entire of my A4 canvas. I'd like a little bit of white area, a little border around the edge. So let's make that. We're going to go to Image and choose Canvas Size. And I'm going to change the units so I'm working in inches. I prefer inches simply because it's smaller numbers and less complicated. So I'm going to change the width to 10 inches and the height to 7 inches. So what I've done there is to take 1 inch off both the width and the height, and that's enough just to give us a little white border around the edge of the picture. And click OK. Now it's going to warn you that you're about to make your picture smaller. Well, yeah, I know, that's what I want to do, so click Proceed. Now that gives us the right dimensions for the height of our panel, but it's the wrong width, it's way too wide. Remember, we've got to get three pictures on that A4 sheet. So let's go back to Image, choose Canvas Size, and we've got to get this a third of the size it is now. Now we can do that by changing the units to percent. So if we wanted to make it a third, we can change the width to 33%. Now that's fine, but once again, you won't have any room for a border around each of the panels. So rather than 33%, let's just make it 30%. Click OK, again proceed, and now you have the exact right size and shape for one panel of your triptych image. Now, a white piece of paper is fine, but you really want to put a picture in there. So let's go back to File and open an image that I want to put in. Now, really for this to work, you do need a landscape picture. You could do it with a portrait picture, but it's going to be really hard. So a landscape is the one to choose. I've got a really wide landscape here, but it doesn't matter. Any landscape will do. Let's go up to Select, Select All, then Edit and copy that picture into the computer's memory. Close it down, don't need it anymore, but back to Edit and choose Paste. Now that's going to paste the picture into the image, but it's a little bit on the small side. We've got a bit of room top and bottom. So we're going to use Edit and Free Transform just to stretch that up so it fills the screen nicely. Just holding Shift so it stays proportional. And I'm going to get a bit of breathing space top and bottom. Now, we can choose what we want to see on this panel by sliding that image around. You can see, although I can't see past the edge, I've got plenty of spare space. So I can have that bit as the first panel on my triptych. Let's go to the layers, and you'll see I have a single layer with the image on. Drag that down to the new layer icon, let go, and you'll get an exact copy. But I don't want it to have exactly the same. I want to move this because this is going to be the second of our three triptych panels. So let's just slide this along until we find something to go there. Yeah, there we go, the castle, that's fine. Copy that layer once again, and we now have the third of our three panels. Again, slide this along until you find something else of interest. Now I quite like this tree with the light coming through. Careful you don't go too far because you will see the edge of the picture and the ones underneath it. So let's move that along so it fits in nicely just there. So that's going to be the three panels for our triptych. All we've got to do now is to move each of those back onto the very first canvas that we made and we shrunk and we minimized it just a few moments ago. So first of all, we'll go for Select and Select All, and then Edit and Copy, and then we'll open the little blank one. Here it is. Edit and Paste, and that'll put the first panel into the picture. You can see it's put it exactly bang in the center of the picture. Really handy. Right, back over to this one again, and let's go back to the layers. We can turn that layer off, work on the next one down, and we'll copy that one as well. Edit and copy, swap over to the other image, edit and paste. There we go. Back to the one with our panels on, close that layer down, work on the bottom one, edit and copy, and for the last time, edit and paste it onto our main image. And we can shut this image down. We don't need the one with all the little panels stacked in layers. We're left with just our main picture, our main triptych image, like so. Okay, so we've got all the individual panels in place, but now we've got to start to lay these out so they look really neat. And the preparation we did just a few moments ago should make this a much easier task. So we're going to move these around using the Move tool, and you'll find you can drag these around. If I hold the Shift key, then they're not going to go off top and bottom. They're only going to go sideways. I'm just going to let them snap in like that. Change layers again to the other one, which is at the bottom of the stack of three, and I can drag that out from underneath. And again, I'm just going to let it snap onto the side. Now, we designed this to have a bit of space around each of the panels, and we're going to put that space in by using the Move tool and holding the Shift key on the keyboard and then pressing the right arrow. Now, because we're holding Shift, this will move this 5 pixels at a time. And if I press this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 times, it puts a nice size gap between the two panels. Go up and work on the other one. Hold the Shift key again. This time use the left arrow key and repeat the process. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So because we used a standard keyboard shortcut, we hold the Shift key, and we repeated the number of pixels 12 steps, it means these two images, these three triptych panels, are all equally spaced out. And that looks really, really good. Trouble is, they kind of just sit on the paper a little bit. So what I want to do now is to put in a border and maybe a drop shadow just to lift them off the whole sheet of paper. And we can do that by using layer styles. And you'll find those, this little FX icon at the bottom of the layers panel. Click that and we'll choose drop shadow. Now drop shadow means we can just change the angle and we'll put a bit of distance and size in there, like so. And whilst we're here, we'll go for the stroke and we'll put the size of the stroke, which is the border effect, let's put that at 10 pixels, change the position to inside and then make it black, not red. And click OK. Now, were you paying attention? Did you see what settings I put in for that adjustment layer? No, nor did I actually. It doesn't matter because there's a neat little shortcut that means that you can copy those effects really quick and simply. And the way we do it is to hold the Alt key on the keyboard, that's the Option key on a Mac, and drag that little F or FX and drop it down onto the layers below. And when you do that, it'll duplicate the layer style so you don't have to do the same work twice. Now, if you want to put a border around on your background, you'll find that you can't. You can't drop the FX icon onto the background because, as with all backgrounds, it's got a little padlock there and that stops anything going onto it. So how do you get rid of the padlock and how do you put an effect on? Well, just double click the layer, rename it to anything you like. You can even call it background if you really want to. As soon as you rename it, the padlock disappears and now you can drag and drop and put your border directly onto that layer. Okay, so there we go. There's how you can make a triptych image from one single photo. I'm Gavin Hoey. Thanks for watching.